Gearhart's back.
The more things change, the more they stay the same.
From NJ1015.com, this is the new Jim Gearhart Podcast.
Well, I'd mentioned the rather dramatic change in time since those days that I was talking about back in, I guess, what you would call, in a sense, the golden days of America, because this is when we had just come out of the war, the first time as a world power. Eisenhower was in heaven, you know, all's well with the world. And things were relatively stable. But the marked contrast with today, it's like going from Stars and Stripes Forever to the political correct... Well, you get the idea. But a couple of things that came up. And one that I remembered, there's a story at a little school called Evergreen College. They're probably a university now. Everybody's got three students in our university. In the state of Washington, I spent a couple of years working in Seattle. And I remember Evergreen State College was a little school. It was the equivalent of what we used to call the state teachers' colleges. Now, they had as their mascot, to show you, a creature, a mascot, called a gooey duck. Now, the gooey duck, if really, this is no kidding, and but if you saw a gooey duck, the first response... A gooey duck has to be the ugliest living creature ever created. It is a giant clam, and I spell G-E-O-D-U-K. It's an Indian word, a Puyallup Indian word, means deep, dig deep, dig fast, because they're very edible. And there's a market for gooey ducks because they are giant clams, but the clam itself is about 3 feet under the sand and this long neck that sticks up. And then you go around and you see that, then they dig the gooey duck out. There's a market for it because they're sold in California as abalone, which would be much more expensive, but nobody knew the difference. A gooey duck, it's like a clam on one end with a shell. But this long neck, and if you see it, the first one I saw was at a very famous place in Seattle called the Pike Place Market. And they had them laid out there in the seafood section. And you look and you're started, looked like a giant black male procreative appurtenance. It's absolutely crazy. So when I saw the Evergreen College, I probably should have known that they're going to do something silly. Well, it was the Evergreen College, university, whatever the heck it is now, that got the bright idea that on some day or days, all the white people should leave the campus. Why? I'm not exactly sure. But the outcome could be a tragic outcome is that one professor, a biology professor, refused to leave. And he was a very liberal person, but he said that was going too far to close down the school for absolutely no reason, and he was not going to leave. Well, the upshot of it is, after a lot of tumult and shouting, that this man is afraid to go back. He left the campus. He had to, under the threats, he had to move his family into some undisclosed location because fear for their lives. And this is how serious this has gotten. You know, we had the shooting of the congressman and all. So this thing has gotten very, very serious. So that was the Evergreen College and their gooey ducks. And we thought the gooey ducks were wacky. Here's another one. There's a town in Wisconsin called Oconomowoc. Oconomowoc. I think I got that right. Never heard of it. But Oconomowoc got in the news because they have a sign as you go into the town that said, "The churches of Oconomowoc welcome you." Well, of course, the Freedom From Religion Foundation and the ACLU and the Justice Warriors and, you know, everybody got together, descended upon the town, demanded they take the sign down, the sign that says, "The churches of Oconomowoc welcome you," is unconstitutional because it is not neutral toward all faiths. What? It just said the churches of. I don't know how you would do that. You put up a sign. It would have to be seven stories high if you had to mention every specific church that welcomed you. And you would have to say the churches, the mosques, the temples, the synagogues. Perhaps they have a Zugarat for Zoroastrians they'd have to put down there. Since this is Wisconsin, there are probably people who worship Gorgonzola the cheese god. And so they would have to have that. It's probably some guy. I picture him as being kind of an average guy named Roscoe B. Evans, who happened to see an image of the Virgin in a jar of Hormel pig knuckles. And so he started a church in his garage. But, I mean, how silly can you get? The Freedom From Religion Foundation said some of the city fathers who have decided that, well, the sign doesn't endorse any religion. What's your problem? But they say that this group, they target communities that are not affluent, who do not have the financial resources to fight back. So they're just out there strictly to cause trouble. That, you know, plainly and simply. So this whole thing going on is absolutely incredible. They had an instance in South Jersey that was somewhat similar to the gooey duck college. We used to call it, you know, the University of Gooey Duck, because it was so silly. Once you saw a gooey duck, you'd never take anything seriously. That was, look it up, G-E-O-D-U-K. You'll love it. But only native, I guess, to the coastal part of the state of Washington. One time, a stupid event took place in South Jersey. I believe it was a Walmart. It could have been one of the other stores, Kmart or something. I think it was Walmart. And just during a regular shopping day, some idiot got on the intercom. I don't think they ever found out who it was, whether he was black, white, you know, Paisley or South Sea slash other ethnically. But he got, and all of a sudden it said, "Attention shoppers, will all black shoppers please leave the building?" And now my guess is, I wasn't there, but I guess most black shoppers just laughed and said, "What a jerk." But there was a lawsuit, actually brought a $1 million lawsuit by a person who wasn't even there. I think he was from Philadelphia, which was some miles away at the time. And he wanted $1 million because this had upset him so much that he couldn't work. And he was having all kind of physical problems. I hope it was thrown out of court, because I never heard any more of that. But it was really scary how people will bring these lawsuits for the most ridiculous reasons. Things like that happen, and they're just stupid. But people do stupid things. It didn't hurt anybody, and it was dumb as hell. And I think, you know, they could have caught the person who did it and taken him out in the parking lot and pelted him with orts would have been fine. But it was scary, because I thought, okay, now what if I go on the air and somebody, a guest or something, says something, anything, doesn't matter what, somebody could say, "Oh, I got so upset by this, I couldn't work." They had, remember one of the Judge Judy episodes. Generally, the Judge Judy episode, the case was always the same. It was a gift, Your Honor. No, Your Majesty. It wasn't a gift. It was a debt. But they had one, and she asked this guy. He was very well dressed, impeccably groomed, very handsome guy of sort of mature years, in a gray flannel pinstripe suit. And she asked him, she said, "Well, what is your occupation, Mr. Stone?" He says, I'm on disability. And Judge Judy said, "Well, what is your disability?" He said, "Your Honor, every time somebody just says the word work, I get all nervous." So the government's giving him disability. So I just throw these out as a couple little examples of how we've gone stark, raving, damn mad. A little bit more to come. I want to get back to the holiday, the 4th of July, coming up after this.